Back to one of our favorite segments, as Amin said, jumping to conclusions.
It's called jumping to conclusions for those of you that are slow. They don't catch on.
Here's how it works. Amin is going to make a statement, and we evaluate.
Yes.
Does it have any shot in hell of happening? Jumping to conclusions. Amin, what is your first conclusion?
All right, the first conclusion, and admittedly, I wrote this before. Before the events of today, the East favorites are not the Cavs and not the Celtics, but the Toronto Raptors. It's right, Rachel, Scotty, and T-Mac. You're talking about a team that has completely overhauled the way they play. Their minutes distribution has gone a lot deeper into the bench. DeMar DeRozan, I don't think he's getting enough credit for how much he changed his game. That's so hard to be an all-star player and someone to come up to you and say, that's not good enough.
Yep.
You got to change, you got to add the three-point shot, and you got to be stop being a ball stopper. I think Toronto, because people kind of get the feeling that they're the same people that they've been the last couple of years, because it's the same faces, it's not the same. It's very different. And before today, I saw a way that Toronto could be the East representatives in the finals, but obviously the Cavs doing all these deals.
What do you got to say to that?
I like it, but I don't believe it's true. I have to see it because these guys have played so well, performed so well in the regular season, but, you know, fall just short of, you know, the expectations that I have for them in the playoffs. I have to see Kyle Lowry. I have to see DeRozan play up to that potential as, you know, they do in the regular season. Doing the same thing that you do in the regular season to the playoffs is not going to get it done. You have to ramp it up a little bit more. And I think, you know, I've seen what Kyrie can do with Boston. I've seen what LeBron James can do. And re-ing up with, you know, this new crew, it's going to be a challenge for him.
I mean, I have to agree with what you've seen. I've seen change in the Toronto Raptors myself, and especially in DeMarcus DeRozan, the fact that he's expanded his game.
Mm-hmm.
He's shooting the three-point, and he's not a ball stopper as much as he's been in the past. He's still a go-to guy, but he's playing a lot different now.
Right.
And I felt bad last season when he paid so much respect to LeBron because I felt like this guy's never going to beat LeBron if he's talking like this. But the fact that he's gotten better as a player, the Toronto Raptors are playing better this season as a team, they do have a chance to challenge for the Eastern Conference, but still LeBron James there and 14 other guys.
I mean, look, they've made it a much more assist-heavy, emphasis on assists, ball movements, three-point shot. There have been times where Kyle Lowry and DeMar DeRozan had not hit the broadside of a barn. The shots are not falling. Do those changes, especially with the increased ball movement, going to help them?
I think it does because a lot of it also is wear and tear that they just rode those two guys until they get to the playoffs and then they've got nothing left. And I think what they've done is what Coach Casey said on our podcast with Mark Spears and Chris Haynes was that we did this knowing that, yes, there are going to be times where I am just going to give it to my best players and everybody get out the way. But that can't be what carries us every day. We got to do something else so that we turn to that in case of emergency and not as a thing that we always do.